Wageningen University and Research has developed many technologies in the field of circular bio-based economy. In this video series, we will look at how these technologies are introduced to the market and reflect on some of the specific challenges that we faced.
Fashion brings us new designs each season. Every year, 80 billion pieces of clothing are sold worldwide. This mass production is shockingly polluting. The dyeing of clothing is one of the most chemically intensive industries in the world. The cotton industry alone is responsible for 24% of the global insecticide use. The production of textiles is the second biggest polluter, right after the oil industry. It's time to find a fashion innovation that outlasts the next season.
I think the value of Wageningen is that we can really contribute to this transformation towards a more circular fashion industry. I think with the technologies and the expertise that we have built over the so many years in food supply chains can be also conveyed or translated to fashion supply chains.
I'm program director for the Bachelor Plant Sciences and the master programs that are connected to that. Wageningen University has developed quite a lot of solutions already for making the food production chain more sustainable. And it appeared in discussions with people from the fashion sector that quite a lot of the solutions are also very well applicable to make the fashion system more sustainable. Plants produce quite a lot of interesting compounds that can also be of use in the fashion sector, for example, as dyes to color fibers, plant-based fibers. Another example of biomimicry is the juniper tree, which produces a waxy layer on the leaves that captures particulate matter from air. And it could be an idea to impregnate t-shirts with that same type of wax so that people wearing those t-shirts can also walk around and capture particulate matter from air. And in that way, we can sort of become walking smog absorbers.
And circular fashion is really about how can we change this system, how can we adjust supply chains in such a way that when we discard our clothing, they can maybe be composted or they can be recycled. This project is disruptive in the way that it really goes beyond the materials that we currently know. Everything can go wrong. Seriously, it's very scary. It's a huge adventure, but we're going for it.
I see myself as a research designer. I discovered when I was printing other textiles I make that there's a lot of waste generated besides the print machine. And I was curious if I can reuse this ink instead of that it is brought to the chemical waste. The last year I've been doing a broad research into this color and to the way it can be reused again. I just don't want to add something extra when there's not thought about how it's made or where it comes from.
Er is zoveel vervuiling en dat houdt een keer op. Ja, dat is de reden waarom ik het zo doe. Ja, voor mij begint het bij het ontwerp. Daarin probeer ik zo tijdloos mogelijk te zijn. De materialen die zijn duurzaam. De productie is duurzaam. We produceren alles in onze eigen studio. Wat ik zelf heel lastig vind is de verfmethodes. Die zijn vaak nog best wel giftig. En als je op een duurzame manier verft, dus met natuurlijke of plantaardige middelen, dat is zo arbeidsintensief. En je krijgt nooit exact dezelfde kleur. En voor productie werkt dat eigenlijk niet.
Starting from a waste stream, working to a high valuable product, that's what I'm passionate about. And this is my way on actually realizing this and having this impact. Actually, the material properties that I can produce are already amazing. It's just a matter of time on how to convert this process to a scalable method. And that's what I'm working on. So we can implement it also and build this industry in the Netherlands.
We researched a lot of materials that can replace a leather within the shoe industry. And we found a couple of super interesting materials. And for this project, I'm going to use like Pinatex, the pineapple harvest. There's rest material, and that material is used to create this beautiful material. I think the fun thing is for scientists is that they look at another way to the product. It's really interesting to get inspiration from that world, to combine it with the other one and make a new kind of product or a new solution.
Dus wat ik eigenlijk ga doen, is ik ga nu heel veel bacteriën verzamelen. Normaal werk ik dus met levende bacteriën en dan werk ik op kleine schaal. En dan is het gewoon plat, is gewoon één plat stuk. Als deze sjaal zeg maar plat moet blijven liggen, moet ik een heel groot bassin hier in de studio gaan bouwen. Je staat elke keer weer voor verrassingen. En je denkt dat het dit wordt, maar in één keer wordt het dat. En om dus te achterhalen wat er nou gebeurd is, heb je natuurlijk een wetenschapper nodig. Maar ook om al die processen uit te voeren. Maar wij kunnen dat natuurlijk zelf, kunnen wij dat niet bedenken van, oh, laten wij nou eens eventjes de pH-waardes van dit gaan veranderen.
Wat vinden jullie?
Ik vind het heel erg mooi.
Ik vind het ook mooi. Hij valt goed, hè?
Ja. Ja. Heel fijn.
Ja. 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 We allebei een beetje voet.
Zowel te breed als te lang, zou ik maar zeggen.
Ik heb een heel smal voetje.
Ik heb een ontzettend
smal
voetje,
ja. Louise fitted the second pair of shoes I made for her. And yeah, we found out that it wasn't really sufficient and the fit wasn't as well as I intended it to be.
Het materiaal heeft gewoon het haak in de ogen.
Het heeft gewoon niet die kracht.
So the material lacks the stretch in it, so the shoe doesn't fit. And that's, yeah, of course, really shameful, but it's part of the process, so it's okay, I hope.
I think the outfit has an amazing story to tell. Of course, it's a disappointment that the shoes didn't work out in the end, but what we want to show is the process. For me, this project is really a prototype of how we can fashion the future. With the technologies and the innovations and the research that we've been doing and that these designers are involved in, we can really make beautiful products like what you're seeing here. So for companies, it's really a matter of, okay, can we adopt these type of innovations and scale them and actually take them to the market?